Hello guys!
Today I'm gonna show you 8 different ways on how you can overdraw your lips. The first way is obviously you're outlining your lips as usual, just making them bigger everywhere. So you're kind of repeating your own shape. If you don't want to correct the shape, if you don't want to correct uneven lips, you can do that. Second way, you're slightly lifting up the middle of your lips, up here and down here, and you lift the corners of your mouth same. What it does, it will make your lips look fuller, it will not make your mouth bigger and wider. It's good for those who already has pretty wide mouth. It looks slightly doll-like. And if sometimes overdrawing your lips, you feel like you look slightly vulgar, that would be a good tip for you. Number 3 is doing opposite to what I just said. So basically you are outlining only the sides. It can look nice on those who has pretty small mouth, big cheeks, or wider jaw. It will take some space away from here, and as far as you're not overdrawing here and on the bottom, your lips will not look super overdrawn. Your mouth will look wider, but make sure it's done very accurate, because sometimes it can look as if you were eating chocolate or something just stuck here in the corners of your mouth. And if you're doing this, make sure that this area is pretty well concealed, so you don't have loads of shadows here or redness, so it would look accurate as possible. Way number 4, lifting the corners up. That's another way to overdraw and making this top lip kind of roll up a little bit, you know what I mean? So basically overdrawing itself is happening only here. I'm gonna do a separate video about this, about how to make it right. And in this case, basically the overdrawing is happening only here, above the corners of your top lip, and it kind of goes to your natural shape. It is slightly correcting the shape of your lips and the downturned corners of the lips. Again, in this case, make sure that you're lightening this area. Number 5. Overdrawing your lips, you can correct some proportions of your face. For example, if you have pretty long nose area and this Cupid's bow area is pretty small, then you can leave your top lip as it is and overdraw your bottom lip. Or if this space is big, you can overdraw your top lip and leave the bottom lip as it is. Same as on the bottom. If you have pretty massive chin, if your chin goes down here in the middle, it's pretty long, so you can overdraw your bottom lip here in the middle as well. It kind of fills in that empty area that you have here, and it balances the whole face. Same with square jaw. If you have pretty square jaw, massive chin here, you can overdraw the whole lip, so it will take away more space from that area. But in this case, make sure that it doesn't look too heavy on the corners. I don't want to say that the corners always have to look up. It's not true, because on some faces, downturned lips look amazing and very sexy. It's just in some cases that can look heavier than usual. So just watch that. If you have that heavy effect, you can rather build some more on the top here on the corners just to balance that so it would not fall down on the sides. Or you can just lift it up earlier here. The way number 6, I call it separate lips overdrawing. It's kind of like a Marilyn Monroe technique where you leave the corners of your lips empty and you can even sometimes lighten them. You're just lining the lips as usual, overdrawing or not overdrawing, it's up to you. And on the corners, you don't connect them together. You just stop before and you kind of go inside of your lip like this. And then you fill it in with a color. It gives very pin-up effect to it. Your lips definitely get bigger. They kind of go forward. It gives a very cute effect. But again, you have to see, sometimes if you make it too bright, it can be pretty visible. Always check it before if this particular way works for you. If that looks super strange on you, you can blend the color a little bit with your finger. But if it still stays light here, your lips will still kind of look separate from each other. It will give that volumizing effect. Number 7. I call it French lips. I don't know why, but I have a feeling that it kind of looks like French lips. So you basically make the top lip bigger and the bottom lip smaller. It gives that very, very cute effect. It will not look vulgar or something. Slightly like Bridget Bordeaux effect. And the additional thing to that, you can make this line more straight, more solid. Just to make that top lip coming forward effect. That will look very cute and very sexy and very French and pretty vintage. And the last one, number 8, uneven lips correction. In case you have an uneven lip like that, you can rather leave it like that because I think it's so beautiful. I love, love, love uneven lips. So I would probably not correct it myself. But I had some questions. Some girls asked me, how can I make my lips more even? Like for the photo set or something like that. So in my next video, I'm gonna show you how to make uneven lips more even with makeup. Just several tips. Thank you so much for watching. Love you and bye-bye.